Happy welcome, dear Simon, to our newest episode of Ask the Founder.
Nice to meet
you.
Likewise.
There are so many questions about what makes the future multiverse unique. And we have counted and we said, okay, there is a comparison to the Glorious Seven or some more, because there are so many unique selling propositions that we have to talk about. There are not only the hyper-realistic graphic, there is multidimensional and the decentrality that the future multiverse brings with it. We have a worldwide well-known network. We have a change of 2D to 3D very fast, and it's possible to flip from one point to another inside the future multiverse. We have a payment gateway that changes fiat to crypto, vice versa. And we have very, very well-known numbers of people in our board. So this is a lot of positions that we can talk about. And not to make it too complicated, we will start with just two of them. Perhaps you can tell us something about the hyper-realistic graphics and the multidimensional of the future multiverse for today. Thank you very much.
Sure. Thank you so much, first of all, for the for today's interview. Very excited about it. I think it's a very important one. I'll start with one, let's say, most important factor and element of that, which is in fact that we are or have accomplished of converging all of those elements that you just mentioned and more in a seamless, simplified way so that it's easy to access and use, and all of those new technologies and new possibilities and opportunities through that, that those are made accessible in an easy way and in a simplified way and in an intuitive way. So everyone, doesn't matter how old they are, how much experience they have with it, it just works. It's like a car. You open the door and you just sit in and you turn it on. And even if you don't completely understand how it works, it works. And it works in an easy and an exciting way, in a seamless way. And that's what we have accomplished. And now we can go into all the details step by step. But I think that's one of the most exciting factors for us, is because our vision was always very simple and straightforward, as we have explained it in more detail in the other interviews. And now we've really made that accessible and easy to use for everyone, and which is important for our upcoming public launch and to scale this now with all of our partners and with our global network.
Yeah, that's very good hear that Future Multiverse is usable for everyone. And you don't need so much technique for that. A simple smartphone is enough. But today, perhaps you can tell us something about the hyper-realistic graphics and the multidimensionality of the future multiverse, because these are some points that you go into it, you see it, and you see, wow, this is hyper-realistic. But what does it mean and what makes it so unique for the future multiverse?
Sure. So let me simplify that. We have consciously and specifically chosen Unreal Engine, and let's say the latest version of Unreal Engine to work with, because it's simply the most advanced and let's say most realistic, let's say, game engine that allows us to really deliver really hyper-realistic graphic that has, with the system that we have integrated, and can deliver more, let's say, frames per second than our eye can even capture. So it's basically, it's able to deliver graphic and experience that is so real that it's very, very difficult to impossible to actually from our eye to defer between, is it, let's say, a digital experience right now that I'm encounter, or is this real?
Avatar 2 has been done with Unreal Engine 5, is that true?
Yeah, as well as other many, let's say, film production companies, they're working with Unreal Engine, save a lot of production costs. They streamline a lot of production costs, and it's a brilliant tool to work with. It's a lot more advanced than other game engines by far. You have to know what you're doing, and it's more, let's say, challenging and complex and advanced to work with. But if you know what you're doing, the differentiation factor to other systems is just incredible. But what we have accomplished is that we really use that in a way that we can completely scale our entire platform, specifically that we can make that entire experience that we have, our entire future multiverse, all the environments that are in there, our whole exhibition on the whole scale of it, plus every single individual environment that is plugged into it in a decentralized way, and we're going to talk about that in a moment, that all of them can be live in the browser. You don't have to download this entire experience to your hardware device, but you can simply access it in the browser and from anywhere, from where you have internet with any device, and not even mandatorily you have to use VR headsets, but you can use a phone, you can use your laptop, your iPad, your computer. And we've really made it possible that such a, let's say, AAA gaming standard, let's say, when we're talking about the resolution, is accessible in a browser-based way and in a seamless way, stable way, so that really everyone can use it and get access to it and can have a brilliant experience. And specifically, that is important for the real world economy. And as we had mentioned several times, we are in the process of, digitizing entire countries, entire nations, starting from the presidential offices to the parliament buildings to economic zones and factories, et cetera, et cetera, and land inventory taking, many different types of projects. So if you don't have a resolution standard like this, plus the scalability factor, plus that it's easily accessible for everyone within a country using the existing infrastructure that is already there. And also, the first question is, where's the data going to be? So that's why the decentralization factor is important. So the hyper-realism that we built and made scalable is a very key factor for the real world economy, because if you have, for example, a factory, let's say an engine, and you want to show, for example, to an investor or to a client, you want to do a product presentation, and you want to present every single little detail and every single little detail in machines like that or in factories matter, then you need, let's say, a standard like that. But then you have to have the, let's say, latency, you have to have, let's say, the seamless experience and, let's say, the stability, and it has to be scalable. And that's what we have accomplished, especially in combination with, let's say, our exhibition, where we bring all of the different partners and clients and community members into walking distance from wherever they are in the world. So you can have, for example, the government, for example, state house, presidential office of a country in Africa or several ones. And then right next to it, you can have a factory that is in China. And potentially that factory in China wants to be positioned in a country in Africa. So easy, the actual decision maker of a country, or let's say the finance minister, can just walk out of the state house, walk across the street and walk into the factory to look at the product and the technology this Chinese company has. And then they can meet in the office, sign a contract and do business through the platform fully seamless. So transactions and things like that become possible, just as one example.
For sure, the more realistic the graphics is, the more
Correct.
fun people have, and the more they believe, and the
Correct.
more trust they can build. So
Correct.
if you
Very
sit
important.
in a room, or if you sit in a fabric, and you say, "Okay, show me your engine," like you mentioned,
Yeah.
you can touch it. Yeah, you can really see what happens. You can
Right.
see each plug and everything, and it
Correct.
makes it much more worth to be part of the future multiverse because of this hyper-realistic graphics.
Hyper-real basically means that it's, it looks even more real than in reality.
We can just invite everyone to visit our YouTube channel to confirm our professionality and the hyper-realistic graphics. So it's
Yes.
really unbelievable.
Our team now, we have a huge team that is working literally 24/7, and we have full scalability. So no matter how big the workload is, we can handle it. And this is also something that is very key for the scalability of our whole platform now.
This is something, the hyper-realistic, that makes it multidimensional. You don't need VR glasses to be part of the future multiverse, so it's really very easy. Just use your smartphone, see whatever. Because of this hyper-realistic graphics, that there are many, many layers, you feel like be 3D without having the VR glasses. So, and this is
Right.
something really special. And
Correct.
yeah.
And regarding the multidimensionality that you just mentioned, the amazing thing is what we have created is, A, we are through our exhibition, our future expo, we are connecting, as I just mentioned, many different partners and clients from all over the world, wherever they are, and we are bringing them into walking distance, close together. So we're bringing together, solutions of different industries with institutions, financial institutions, potential investors, corporate investors, governments, plus agents or agencies who can, let's say, or are specialized in connecting the different parties with each other. And so everyone can benefit from it, G to B to B to C. And so the whole pipeline in a top professional way. And multidimensionality also means that you can, for example, you can start the entering process into that entire platform from a 2D perspective. So if you're looking for something specific, for example, a certain motor or a certain engine or a certain whatever tool for your working on whatever, you can start searching for it on our marketplace. So after you logged in, you can go to the marketplace and then you can first read about it and look at, let's say, images, maybe an intro video, and then read about the backgrounds. And then you can say, now show me this in 3D or in VR. And then you can just click one button and then it navigates you directly in our future expo with an avatar, either with your own one or with the avatar of that company, or a, let's say, representative of that company, to that specific item in that exhibition. And then you can experience in 3D and then say again, great, I want to buy this now. So it brings you directly to 2D again. So it's like a seamless conversion from 2D to 3D. And also when you're inside of that, the exhibition or in the future multiverse, you have another another search engine, and you can basically look for any item that is in the future multiverse or in that exhibition. You can press enter, then it shows you different environments, it shows you different companies. You can search for one specific company if you want to. You can click on the company, then it shows you all the different items that are tied to that specific company. You click on one, and then it could be, for example, an office, a specific office desk with a specific number, for example, in a specific office building, and you could directly jump there with your avatar.
But this is
So it's all
something
interconnected. Yeah.
for another episode.
Regarding
So
the
don't
multidimensionality.
be too specific now. We just learned something about hyper-realistic and multidimensional. And thank you very much for this episode,
Thank you.
Simon. We will go deeper into the other points. And for now, we just say follow us for the next episode. Thanks for watching
Excellent.
today. And we will be here back soon. Have a nice day.
Thank you so
Bye-bye.
much.